access. So if you are using Windows 7 or Windows 8, you might need to go to the Start menu and look for Control Panel. And you click on it. And as soon as you have the Control Panel, you please be careful that it might be aware of the fact that it might not show the same as it's showing in my computer. It might show you, depending on the view by, if it's a small category, it should show you like this, or if it's a large icons, it should show you like this. But anyway, make sure to change it to category. If you have Windows 8 or Windows 10, they are similar. And to go to Network and Internet, and then Network and Sharing Center. And then you click twice in your Wi-Fi to open it. We will see how we will set it up and to fix that problem. For the people who they have Windows 10, they can use the same way, or they can use a shortcut. You can click on your Wi-Fi using the right side or the right button of the mouse, and you look for Open Network and Sharing Center, and you click on Internet. So basically, the main problem with the internet is that there is a problem with the IP address, or there is a problem on the on your router. So when you go to properties, it takes some seconds to open, and then please make sure to select the internet protocol. So as soon as you select Internet Protocol version 4, you click on Properties. And here you have two choices. Either you will choose the first choice, is to obtain an IP address automatically and obtain the server address automatically. You click OK. And as soon as you click OK, you will need to click again OK here, and you close this window, and then it should work. If it doesn't work for you, then all you might need to do is to search for CMD, command prompted. You click on it with the right side of the right button of the mouse, and you choose Run as administrator. And then you click Yes. It will open for you. And here you will your type ipconfig so that you can get your real IP address. So my physical IP address for IPv4, it's 192.68. It's usually coming as these numbers. And you need to remember these three, or you can just put them in front and type them. So we will try to manage to get all. So let's just put it a little bit like this. Cool. So now we will click use the following IP address, and you need to retype exactly the same. So for IP address, you will type the first line 192.168, and you type your own number and you continue. Then you go to the next, and here sometimes it type automatically, sometimes not. So make sure please to type 255, 255, 255 in the subnet mask, and in the end you type a zero. In the default gateway, you will type again your IP address with a small difference. So you type again your IP address, and in the end you will not put 100, but you will put 1, like in the default gateway. And in your DNS server, you will choose addresses, and here you will choose 8888, and again 88, and here you will choose 4 and another 4. Please make sure that you check back again. If you miss any number, or if you type a wrong number, please make sure to correct it. Otherwise, there is going to be a problem. And as soon as you type all this, you click Validate Settings upon exit. And here you click OK. And after this, you just close, as I said. And for sure, your internet should be working. I will just close mine, it will take a while. What's next? The next step is your system will try to detect any problems with your network, and the system will try to repair it if you are using Windows 10 or Windows 7 or even Windows 8. Otherwise, if there is no problem detected, then your internet should be working fine. All what you need to do is to check your internet back, and everything should be okay. It will take just between few seconds and few minutes, and not more than 5 minutes, and it should be okay. As I said, it changed automatically to connected. So for me, I don't need internet for the moment, so I will just deactivate it. And going back here, when your system detects any problem, it will refer to you, and then you can explore additional options. Otherwise, as here it says, troubleshooting couldn't identify the problem. So then there is no problem with my wireless anymore, with my Wi-Fi anymore. So you just press OK and close. Please make also sure to check if your device driver is up to date. So all what you need to do while connected to internet or not, you check if your driver are installed. You type device manager. Sorry, it was too fast. So you come here, you go to the search tab and you type device manager. It doesn't matter if you are using Windows 10, Windows 8, or Windows 7, this is the same perspective. And you click here with the right side of the mouse. Sorry, we click with the mouse and it will open to you this window. It's called Device Manager. It show you the drivers of your computer if all the hardware drivers are installed. So you go next to network adapter, and please make sure that there is nothing with yellow triangle with yellow sign here. So as you can see here, everything is installed, everything is working, there is no yellow sign. So if you want to make sure that your driver are up to date, you just click on this one and sorry, you click on update driver software and then search automatically for update software. And if you're connected to internet, it should be working and it will show you. If your driver need to be updated, the system will tell you and the system will help you and guide you. If not, then it will say as here, Windows has successfully updated your driver software. So as you can see, my computer just finished to update my software. If not, if my driver was up to date, the system will say that my driver is up to date. I hope this video was helpful to you guys. If you need help, assistance, you can always contact us via email or you can put for us a comment and we'll be replying to your comments. Please do not forget to subscribe, share, and like. And if you have any question, please do not hesitate to contact us. We are here to help you. Thank you, everyone, and we wish you to have a good day.